Hello, you're watching Ocarina Owl, the place you go to for fun ocarina tutorials, songs, and more. This is lesson 4 of the How to Play the 12-hole Ocarina tutorial series. In this lesson, we will cover 3 things. 1, the C major scale with 2 additional low notes covering the subhole. 2, the F major scale, a new scale that includes B flat. And 3, finally, 3 different songs. Part 2 of Zelda's Lullaby, Who Killed Cock Robin and the Canadian Shanty, Bonavist Harbor. Let's get started. This week's C major scale will include the 2 notes low B and low A. For low B, you must cover the subhole on the right hand. Or if you're using the Japanese style subholes, you must cover the second subhole. Low A is when you cover both of the subholes. This is also the lowest note possible on your ocarina. Here is the C major scale with low B and low A added at the end. Notice that when playing low B and low A, those 2 notes require a good amount of low breath control. You need to make sure you blow very warm air into your ocarina like this. The F major scale starts on F and includes 3 new notes. First one is called B flat. It's just like a regular B, but we also add finger number 3 on the 3rd tone hole on the right hand. It sounds like this. We also have as a new note, high E. High E is similar to high D that we learned last week, where we removed the thumb hole on the right hand, but for high E, we remove both thumb holes, leaving only the pinky. High F, which is the highest note on the scale, covers no tone hole on the ocarina. It's also open. Here is the F major scale. To get a really clear sound on the highest notes, remember the tip of last week about a cute bend. Remember to bend the ocarina straight down like this. It really helps to get that clear tone. Start practicing the F major scale this week in the same progression we did the C major scale. Half notes, quarter notes, eighth notes, and if you can, 16th notes. This is part 2 of Zelda's Lullaby. Thank you. Notice that part 2 is very short and includes low A. After part 2 is done, then repeat part 1 the same way we played it at the beginning. If you need to look back at my video from last week, I've left a link below. This is a traditional English folk song and rhyme named Who Killed Cock Robin? The hardest part of this song is going from low D to high D. I would suggest practicing this a couple of times, but one tip to get it sounding really smooth is to make sure that you slur or say on the same syllable the two notes like this. It may seem like you're sliding, but in the end a little bit of sliding will sound so much smoother on the ocarina. Our final song for today is called Bonavist Harbor. It's a Canadian sea shanty. This song is in 6/8 time. That means there are 6 beats per measure and the 8th note gets the beat. I'll turn on the subdivision so you can hear it on the metronome. Here it is without the subdivisions. As always, I've linked the music for this lesson down in the description. Please go practice so you can be ready for lesson 5 next week. Thank you so much for watching this week's episode of Ocarina Owl, lesson 4 for the 12-hole Ocarina tutorial series. If you want to support my channel, don't forget to like, share, comment, subscribe, and do all those great things you guys do. If you've already done all those things, then don't forget to follow me on social media. I've left the links down below for my Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and my website. Until next time, this is Ocarina Owl, signing out. A flat is when you step one chromatic pitch down. It looks kind of like this. By the way, my t-shirt reads, "Without music, life would be flat."